I have a problem when it comes to reviewing products like the Geek and Gorgeous A-Game. I've been using tretinoin for my adult acne for years now, so judging how anything weaker really affects your skin is nearly impossible. If I didn't have a secret superpower. Not a second face on the back of my head, no, a big family with different skin types and skin concerns. So whenever I want to talk about a retinoid, I hand it over to one of them, and because today I want to talk about both the 0.1% and the 0.05% version, I actually recruited two of my sisters as guinea pigs, one with severe hyperpigmentation concerns and one with sensitive skin. Here's the review. Hi, I'm Dr. N. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. The difference between retinal and retinol. I have a video dedicated to the different retinoids and how to pick the right one for your skin type and concern here, but as there is often some confusion, here's a quick recap. Retinyl palmitate, retinol, and retinaldehyde are precursors of retinoic acid, which is the active form in the skin. Each one needs a different number of conversion steps until it reaches the active form, and the more conversion steps there are, the less the effect and the irritation potential will be. Retinol is the most common one, as it has a lower risk for irritation while still delivering results over time. Retinaldehyde or retinal is one step closer to the active form, so stronger, but with more irritation potential. You don't see many retinal products on the market, probably due to the fact that it is hard to formulate with in terms of stability, which is why I am excited to see it used in the A-Game formula. What the Geek and Gorgeous A-Game serum claims. A silky light emulsion containing a medium strength amount of retinal to help against all signs of aging while being gentle on the skin. Texture and scent. The Geek and Gorgeous A-Game serum feels more like a lotion than a watery serum, but lightweight. It is yellow in color and has no noticeable scent. My sister using the A-Game 10 with 0.1% retinol reported a little bit of stickiness and the tendency of the product to transfer to her pillowcase and even stain it if she was using a white one. That could be solved by doing her routine at least 30 minutes before bedtime, so the product could sink in completely, and was not reported by the other sister using the 0.05% version, but you might want to keep that in mind if you have expensive bedding or even silk pillowcases like I have. How to use the Geek and Gorgeous A-Game Serum. How you as an individual best use it depends on how sensitive your skin is to retinoids. I talk more about that in my video on how to minimize irritation with retinoids, but what you always should do is use it at night, as all retinoids are sensitive to UV light. Both my sisters use theirs in the evening after cleansing and after using a niacinamide serum, as niacinamide and retinoids work great together. You can follow up with a moisturizer if you feel the need to, but don't have to. This again depends on your skin type. It is worth noting that both my sisters reported that one pump is too much for the face, around half a pump dispenses the correct amount. Ingredients of Geek and Gorgeous A-Game. You will obviously find retinaldehyde in the formula, as well as glycerin as humectant and panthenol for skin soothing. One thing I want to quickly point out here is the cyclodextrin. Cyclodextrin is a cyclic oligosaccharide, basically a sugar molecule cycle, that has the ability to encapsulate lipophilic molecules inside. You might remember that I told you that retinaldehyde is hard to formulate with. Well, having it encapsulated is a solution to that problem, as the encapsulation keeps it protected in the formula. Another brand I know of using cyclodextrin as a mechanism to stabilize their retinol is Medicaid, and their crystal retinol is very popular, but also much more expensive. Now, don't get me wrong here, I'm not claiming one is a dupe for the other. They have different formulas, and even if they hadn't, you can't tell a dupe just by the ingredient list. All I am saying is that this technology is established. How does it compare to the Inkey list retinol? Well, obviously, one is a retinol and one is a retinal, which makes them different already. But to be honest, I have yet to try another retinal product that I could compare the Geek and Gorgeous one to, as I said, they're very common. Until now, I have recommended the one from the Inkey list as a good starting point, which still is true, but now that I have seen that the 0.05% works well even on more sensitive skins, I think I'd recommend that one instead. Which skin types do I recommend it to? due to the fact that there are two strengths available, even beginners and those with more sensitive skin should be able to use it when introducing it slowly. You know, I'm a huge fan of retinoids and think it's a great way to address most skin concerns, with the obvious exception of actual acne that will most likely benefit more from an actual prescription. For readily available cosmetics though, this is a great option. Have you tried the retinol already? And if you have, what were your experiences? Tell me in the comments below. Don't forget, if you want to get a say in which topics I discuss next or which products I'd like to review, head over to my Patreon account where you get a vote. I'm going to link to more videos on the screen now that I think you might enjoy, and I'm going to see you all very soon with another one. Bye!